Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market has recorded a decent price decrease for the last 24 hours. And in my view, because of this decline, I would say that this is some kind of, let's say, quiet volatile consolidation, and this happens after the solid price increase. So now the prices of the cryptocurrencies are just consolidating. And today I want to mention one story, actually event that happened to a friend of mine, and it is related to the cryptocurrency market and to the current situation in the cryptocurrency market. And a few days ago, a couple of days, or probably 3 or 4 days ago, a friend of mine wanted to transfer a piece of Ethereum to from his wallet, online wallet or mobile wallet, to some exchange. And it turned out that the commission was relatively high. So he was supposed to pay approximately at least $1.50 or preferably $2 in order to be able to transfer this small piece of Ethereum. Let's say the value of this small piece of Ethereum was approximately $15, something like this. And he decided to abstain from conducting, transactions on Ethereum blockchain at the moment because of those high transaction fees. And let me show you how the chart of the transaction fee per on Ethereum blockchain looks like. So the current price is over $3. It used to be 11 cents, 15 cents, 20 cents earlier this year or in the middle of the year. And now it is relatively high. And it happens because when the market increases, when the prices of the cryptocurrencies increases, so this is the increase of the prices of the cryptocurrencies, then many new people, they jump into the market, they join the market. Other cryptocurrency users, they become more active, and it increases the number of transactions on chain. And when the number of transactions increases with scalability issue unsolved, then the price per or the commission, the transaction fee increases. And of course, when Ethereum experienced this solid price increase recently, many people started to buy Ethereum. The activity on Ethereum blockchain increased, and it triggered this increase of the transaction fee. And now when the transaction fee is high, many people will make a break. They won't be that active on the blockchain of Ethereum, and they will wait for lower transaction fees, for a period of lower transaction fees. And that's why it puts pressure on the price of any cryptocurrency, in our case of Ethereum. The same holds for Bitcoin. The current transaction fee is $5. It's too much. If you want to transfer just dollar or two, you won't use Bitcoin because that is really very expensive. And this is because of the scalability issue. We know that, for example, the limit of one block or the size of the block on the blockchain of Bitcoin is 1 megabyte. And with all this SegWit and new implementations, upgrades that were implemented 2 or 3 years ago, the size is 1.3, something like this. And now with this scalability issue, because all of those blocks on the blockchain of Bitcoin, they are full and it cannot scale. We know that Bitcoin handles on average 5 to 7 transactions per second. This is the limit because of the scalability issue. And because of it, if we check the number of transactions per day, it has been moving sideways for quite some time. And let me show you when the scalability issue occurred. It occurred in the very beginning of 2017 or in the last months of 2016. And since then, we see that the number of transactions per day is moving sideways in some broad range, something between, let's say, 300 and 400, or let's say even 500 transactions per second. But this is not enough for this cryptocurrency ecosystem to grow substantially. And because of this scalability issue, this is a solid burden for the price of any cryptocurrency, in our case of Bitcoin, Ethereum, and etc. And I want to say that this scalability issue is the biggest problem for the cryptocurrencies, and we see once again with this scalability issue when we have a limited block size of this blockchain, the ecosystem cannot handle more transactions, and when the demand for this cryptocurrency increases on chain, I mean, the transaction fee increases as well, and at some time, it becomes very expensive to conduct transactions via this cryptocurrency. And I want to say that this is the key problem of all those proof-of-work cryptocurrencies. They cannot scale easily. This scalability issue is unsolved in the ecosystem of Bitcoin, and this is one of the problems for the price to grow. Of course, there are other exogenous factors that may affect the price of any cryptocurrency, and we're very familiar with them because I used to talk actively about them since the beginning of the year. This is the loose monetary policy conducted by the central banks all over the world. This is the increase of money stock M2 in the United States. So we see that M2 added almost 3 trillion within the last couple of months, and because of this money printing all over the world by the central banks, it affects positively the prices of many financial assets, including the cryptocurrencies. So this is just an exogenous factor that is positive for the prices of the cryptocurrencies. But if we analyze once again the ecosystem of those cryptocurrencies, most of them have this solid scalability problem or issue, and this is a solid burden for the price to grow. And I think that if one day the scalability issue is solved, then we will witness the beginning of a new solid sustainable bull run. This is my point of view. So fellas, that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next one. It was me at CryptoSpa.